Attention all video content creators. Are you tired of wasting precious hours resizing and reframing your videos for various platforms? Well, listen up, because I've got a game-changing solution for you. It's 2023, and the struggle to adapt your content for LinkedIn, TikTok, YouTube, Instagram, and beyond is real. There are more social networks now than ever before, but what if I told you there's a way to do it automatically? That's right, no more manual adjustments. Hi, I'm Mike Russell from Music Radio Creative, a seasoned video editor with over 20 years of experience. And today, I'm going to reveal the ultimate time-saving tool that has revolutionized my workflow. This is the secret weapon that will transform the way you work, and trust me, time is money in this industry. So buckle up and get ready to see how you can supercharge your video editing process with this groundbreaking feature. Don't miss out on this game-changing tutorial. Let's dive right in. Okay, take a look. I've got a little mix here I made from a transcript earlier, so I've really just shortened down to nearly 20 seconds a little bit of content from one of my AI videos. So I'm really excited now to use the power of Adobe's text-based transcribing and captioning AI to really make something that pops. Now, first of all, obviously you see this is a horizontal video, which is great for big screens. It's not so great for devices where we might watch shorter form videos. So we want to make it vertical. Adobe Premiere Pro makes it super easy to make a vertical video. So here I am on the screen, and you'll notice in the first cut, I move around a lot. I kind of bob my head around. So that's kind of awkward in vertical video because, you know, it's got to, like, I'll go out of frame and it won't look quite great. But if I right-click this sequence that I've been working on and I click Auto Reframe Sequence, I can simply tell it, look at this, I can make it square, say if I want it to go on Insta, or I can make it vertical, which is great for shorts, TikTok reels, stuff like that. And motion tracking is on by default. We can do a slower motion or a faster motion if needed. So faster might be good if you're filming sport, and slower if there's not too much activity going on. Everything else leave as default. Click create and boom, look at that. It has made a fantastic, and look at how it tracks me there on the screen. It actually follows me in, and I'm going to get started straight away with the best, in my opinion. It's 11 laps. So that is really, really cool. So it's tracking me, it's following me, and this is fantastic. Even when I go to my screen share, it kind of follows around and gets onto the part of the screen that needs to be in view. So I'm impressed. And it follows my mouse right the way down to when I click the button as well. So everything is framed and created perfectly for a short form vertical video. Now I need those captions to go in so I can really make this pop out and look like a short form video. And in order to do that, I'm going to go over to the captions tab up here in the top left, and it's as simple as create captions from transcript, and we can go for subtitle default. That's probably the best thing to go for. You've got captioning preferences as well, so you can go into that if you really have a specific idea of how you want those captions to look, but the defaults look pretty good. And let's create those captions, and here they are. Now you'll see they're a little bit small, okay, at the moment. So let's go ahead and go to the captions and graphics workspace here. And if I go into edit over here and select my captions, I can now go ahead and maybe make those captions a little bit bigger. And I can also fill them with maybe a different color that's suitable for my channel's brandings. And then I can play back and check a look at this. Hop straight in, and I'm going to get started straight away with the best, in my opinion. It's 11 labs. Now notice that I said it's 11 labs and it used the number 11 labs. Again, I can edit this to be absolutely accurate. So in this case, it's going to be all one word, 11 labs. And there you go. It automatically updates the captions that appear on the video as I type into the captions box. So it works really, really well. So there you go. That is how you grab a video that you've edited and make it into a vertical for shorts, and also pop up captions so it looks really awesome on any device. I hope you enjoy doing this. And if you've got any questions, let me know in the comments down below.